Sunset in Alaska, yeah. Welcome. Welcome everyone. In Valdez, Alaska. It's about 8:30. This is the salmon run. The pinks are finally coming in. Full stop. Millions of fish ready to get harvested by the hatchery and all the other wildlife. All of that is fish. Pink salmon. Waiting for the fish ladder to open. They'll get harvested. And then they'll become future generations. Hmm. Hi, Blue. Yeah, I gave up on the boat for tonight. I'm gonna come catch some, fill my cooler, so that way I can at least go home with some fish. Yeah, I know, there definitely wasn't this many fish this whole last week. Out swamped. Looks like there's a few small silvers in there mixed in too. Hey, Fall Alaska, are you down here in Valdez working this week? Nope, he left. He was in and out. I don't know if this is gonna work, but I'm gonna try it. Yeah, they do. Tons of energy. I'll keep it going, but I'm gonna go grab my pole, put it together, start catching some fish, fill in the cooler.
after.
I guess if I do it from my hood, then I could probably still see and read everything. Thank you. Hey, Steven. Welcome. Don't mind me, everybody. I'm just putting a new swivel on. No, it's kind of impossible to not catch fish when they're this thick, but I'll have to be careful of what I actually show, because I guess if I show anything too bad, then TikTok doesn't like it. But I got my rod and reel. We're going to go fishing. I'll try and set up where you guys can kind of still see. As you can see, if it rotates around here, there are people fishing down here. She's got one. Also don't want to get too wet because I'm not wearing waterproof shoes. But yeah, even out here at the shore, I don't know how well it's going to come through. You can see how thick they are in through there. All right, let's keep walking down. Thank you. Thank you, Halu. All right, do a quick pan of the inlet here. This little kid's got one. All right. Let's see if I can find a flat rock up here to set this on. Whoop! Nope, that one's not flat enough. Yeah, there we go. That one should work. That last one was a big one. I'll hold them up in a little bit, but that was six. That's the daily limit. It's called catching, not fishing, when they're this thick. I'll start again tomorrow before I decide if I'm gonna stay again or head out, since I can't get the boat fixed. It's looking like I need a new engine. That's the downside. I don't know if you see that. That's a big one for a pink. Anyways, 8, 16, almost 20 inches, maybe. Yep, all of them are pinks. Thought I might have had a small silver in there. But nope. So. Head back to the car and give you a view. And see, it hasn't been that long, but you can see that sandbar. The tide is quickly going out. Halo, yes, I will smoke these and then can them. Better than tuna fish. But the pinks, right now, these have already started to turn, so to speak, so the meat's a little soft. So that's really all you can do with them. But yep, I'll smoke them and and then can them. It was only $350. I bought it at Valdez Outfitters. Alright, now that the work is done, let's go take a look again and enjoy the scenery. Maybe with the boat being broken, I mean, I'll definitely be back to pull it out of the water, but I gotta fix the trailer first. You know, things happen in three. First it was the trailer, then it was the boat, now it's my truck. And I can't get the boat back without the trailer. I can't get either of them back without the truck. So maybe. Silvers I haven't ever really been too successful snagging, because you can see the quantities of the pinks and they get all mixed in with those. But trolling out there in the bay and the harbor, I'm usually pretty successful with them. But if not, I prefer the silvers personally. They're one of my favorites. Reds would be my top choice, but I haven't ever gone fishing for those. People tend to dip net for those out at the Chittenah River. But you need to have a riverboat for that, because the water moves so fast that you can't really fish it. I do have Cash App. I also have PayPal. This might date myself. I've had PayPal since 1999. But, yep, links in the bio, I do have that. So, hopefully this next week I'll be able to get parts and get the trailer and then get the boat out. KRX Levy, yes, this is real. This happens every summer, July through September. Here in Valdez, what you've got is, you've got over here to our right, you've got the hatchery right on the ocean where the water meets, and they go and they harvest the pinks and then they harvest the silvers later. So the pinks have been coming in now for about 3-4 weeks. Obviously there's a lot more today than there has been since a while, the last week that Blue Nomader has been streaming. It's been a lot, but not this many. The trailer on the way down, because of a construction zone, shattered a leaf spring. And then the boat is no longer cranking over. It's not the starter. And it wouldn't run. I had to come back on the kicker 30 miles. It took 10 hours. And now I can't get it to turn over manually. So now it's time to pull it out and probably pull the engine. Because if you can't crank it by hand, something's stuck that shouldn't be. So thank you. Whoever that was. Oh. sneaky. So. And then with the truck, it's probably got a cylinder that's losing compression, and it's a diesel, so it's the 6-bloater. So I got to take that in and get that figured out. It runs rough. Maybe, hopefully, just a bad injector. But the injectors are only 2 years old. I did quite a bit of work to it a couple years ago just because I was pulling my heavy slide-in camper and the boat. So that way I would make sure that the engine was good and solid for a while. Come on up, Levi. It's Valdez, Alaska. You fly into Anchorage, and then you can either drive here, or you can fly into Fairbanks, which is in the middle of the state, and then drive here. The drive's about the same, although I'm a little biased. The drive from Fairbanks is a lot better. Anchorage people are, they're city folk. Getting parts in Alaska is not too shabby. We've got Napa, O'Reilly's. Amazon now has a direct flight. I work for a cargo airliner, and we contract maintenance with Sun Country Air. And there's an Amazon Prime flight that comes every night. So we're actually getting stuff in decent time now. It is funny, though, when you call people and have to remind them that Alaska is, in fact, part of the U.S. It is not international. So Valdez, Alaska, the smorgasbord known as the Pink Salmon Run. Oh, thank you, Sarah. That is awesome. Blue, do you remember who said this would be peaceful to go to sleep? I don't know, with all these seagulls. I don't know how you do it. The other side's a lot quieter. Yep. It'll only get worse. They're picking at all the dead carcasses now that tide's going out. We'll take a walk down here. We'll give it a few minutes and then I'll head over to the other side and clean the catch. Yeah, there's a ton of seagulls and fish. So here we go. There's all the fish. It said you can't enter beyond that, so I entered after it. They don't really like people coming down here, but it's also not enforced, so I don't know. Is an unenforced law actually a law? Thanks, Siddiqui. I hope I didn't butcher it too bad. We'll call you Sidekick Man. That's all right with you, Sidekick. I'm not gonna lie, the sun's setting, which won't set for a couple hours, but that yellow, that glow on the building is just amazing. If you haven't followed Blue, she's been out here for about a week and a half doing lives, making me jealous because I had to be at work instead of down here in Valdez. So make sure you give her a follow too. She'll be here for the foreseeable future, at least another couple weeks, if not a couple months. And she's been doing this every day. Sunset probably about 10:30ish tonight, so we still got about another hour and a half of sunlight. So, and then the mountains. Hi, Callie. Almost sunset time, almost nighttime. I won't blind you. It's beautiful today. I don't know if Blue would agree with me that I'd call it warm, but for me it was warm. 60 and sunny, that's warm for me. The breeze has finally died down, the water's dying down, and it's just absolutely beautiful. Come on up, we love visitors. If it weren't for the visitors, we'd have to rely on the oil. Hi, Angie. Welcome. Yes, I truly am blessed to live here. Although if you don't like the cold, Alaska's not the place for you. Up in Fairbanks, I tell everybody 9 months, expect snow the second week of September through the middle of May. But usually it doesn't show up till October, and usually by May it's gone. But if you figure at least 6 months of cold temps and you can deal with that, then Alaska's the place for you. I like the cold weather after multiple deployments. I just don't like the heat. Was at Campbell for 6 years, hot and humid. It's not for me. Welcome, Bobby. Yeah, it is. I don't want to attempt it, but you could probably walk across the fish. That's how thick it is right now. So if you haven't followed either Blue or myself, both have lots of content about Valdez. Later this winter I plan to do lives when the Northern lights are out. But you gotta wait till it gets dark. You can't see them if it's not dark. So make sure you follow. I don't know how often I will do a live. But obviously when you're down here and this is the scenery, you kind of have to share. Aloha. You'll have to invite her, Papa. I don't know if she'll still be here. But yeah, the amount of fish is just crazy. Mr. Nice Guy, yes, it was out in the ocean. I don't know how far away it was. There was a tsunami warning that was later canceled. So I was still in Fairbanks when it happened. I took the drive down this morning. Got here 3 o'clock this afternoon. Started working on the boat. Gave Blue a high five. Ate some dinner. Caught my 6 fish. And now I need to go clean them and get them packaged and on ice. So thanks everybody for watching, but I think I'm gonna call it a night, go get the fish cleaned, and be back later.